Getting a healthy balance of vitamins and minerals is important for everybody, but there's one vitamin that's particularly important for preventing nerve damage, one of the worst and most common problems that come with high blood sugar. Many diabetics either don't get enough of it or can't adequately absorb it. So today we're going to look at vitamin B12, why it's so important, and how to make sure you're getting enough. This is particularly important for people who don't eat much meat. But even if you do eat B12-rich foods, certain factors can block your body's ability to even absorb it. We've got you covered with ways to avoid these problems. Make sure you subscribe to Diabetics Talk for more practical diabetes information. Plus, stick around to find out how you can get 3 free gifts to help you prevent and fight diabetes. Imagine for a moment the vast web of nerves in your body, around 45 miles worth if they were lined up end to end. Billions of neurons keeping you alive by carrying messages to and from the brain. Now imagine if these intricate connections started to rust and short circuit. This is one of the worst complications of high blood sugar and one of the most common. In fact, by the time an individual is diagnosed with diabetes, a staggering 18% already have nerve damage. Even pre-diabetics, people starting and standing on the threshold, are not spared. Excess glucose in the blood initiates a series of events that destroy nerves. One primary mechanism is called glycation, where excess glucose attaches itself to proteins, forming harmful compounds called advanced glycation end products, or AGEs. These AGEs accumulate in nerve cells, causing inflammation and damage to the nerve structure. Furthermore, high blood sugar can impair the blood vessels that supply your nerves with nutrients and oxygen. When these vessels are compromised, your nerves essentially become malnourished and starve. Like a plant without water, nerves deteriorate. The first indications of neuropathy can feel like electric shocks jolting through your body, pins and needles, pain, tingling, or hot and cold sensations. As it gets worse, your body is less able to heal, especially in faraway regions like the feet. This leads to ulcers and small cuts that become infected, which can trigger gangrene and can require amputation. Likewise, elevated blood sugar damages nerves in the eyes, causing blurry vision, dark spots, and blindness. Vitamin B12 is vital to keeping all of these nerves protected through the myelin sheath, which we'll go into in just a second. However, first, let's discuss that fact that diabetics are notoriously low in vitamin B12. With reports suggesting that more than half of people with type 2 diabetes may have a B12 deficiency. A groundbreaking 2021 study published in the journal Nutrients highlighted just how important vitamin B12 is. The study involved 90 type 2 diabetics who were already showing signs of neuropathy and were also deficient in B12. Over 12 months, participants received either daily B12 supplementation or a placebo, with the results showing a significant improvement in several nerve indicators, including vibration perception threshold, which gauges how well an individual detects vibrations, and thus how well nerves are communicating with the brain. In everyday life, the ability to detect vibrations, temperature, and other tactile sensations plays a critical role in many ways we take for granted. For example, if you touch a hot surface, the immediate sensation of heat warns you to withdraw your hand. Sensory feedback from our feet and legs is vital for maintaining balance. And many tasks like typing, sewing, or even tying shoelaces rely on tactile feedback, essentially enabling us to live independently. More significantly, though, the research showed that pain sores improved by 7% when B12 deficiency was corrected. These findings reinforce previous research showing that vitamin B12 aids in the regeneration of the myelin sheath, the insulation surrounding nerve fibers, protecting these sensitive fibers and allowing proper nerve conduction. But why are diabetics so vulnerable to B12 deficiency? The truth is, multiple factors come into play. One of the most striking is metformin, the commonly prescribed drug for managing blood sugar. What's not commonly known is that metformin has a side effect of decreasing vitamin B12 absorption. Numerous studies have found this, such as the 4.5-year randomized clinical trial in the Netherlands, which found that people taking metformin has a 19% decrease in the amount of vitamin B12 that their body could absorb, meaning that anyone taking metformin should be aware and increase their B12 intake if needed. More on this shortly. Other medications, such as proton pump inhibitors and histamine blockers, commonly used for acid reflux, have also been shown to reduce B12 absorption. Next, a factor that none of us can avoid. As we age, our bodies naturally become less efficient at absorbing vitamin B12. For many years, the medical community considered a B12 blood level of more than 150 picomoles per liter to be adequate. However, there's a growing belief that for diabetics over 60 years of age, this level should be more than 400 picomoles per liter. We'll talk about how to make sure you're getting enough soon, but first, there's one more factor to consider: alcohol. Yes, the occasional drink might seem harmless, but alcohol can interfere with how your body absorbs and uses vitamin B12. For diabetics already at risk of B12 deficiency, this can be an added setback. Alcohol is a double whammy, not only affecting vitamin absorption, but also having a direct toxic effect on nerve health, known as alcohol neuropathy. In fact, studies suggest that up to 60% of alcoholics may have some form of alcohol neuropathy. Of course, you don't need to be an alcoholic to experience damage, but that's the group that scientists could study. Beyond nerve health, too much alcohol damages the liver, pancreas, stomach lining, and can lead to high blood pressure, accelerating the complications that come with diabetes. So if you do choose to drink alcohol, moderation is key, with most guidelines suggesting an upper limit of 1 standard drink per day for women and 2 standard drinks per day for men. A growing body of research also shows enormous benefits from periods of abstinence, like the famed Dry July, a month off alcohol. Before we get into improving B12 intake, how about those free gifts? Discover an entire world of diabetes-fighting foods with our new book, 10 Incredible Foods That Reduce Blood Sugar. Plus, you'll discover the real reason why type 2 diabetes, obesity, and heart disease are increasing at an alarming rate, and find out what really works when it comes to preventing these illnesses by watching our free diabetes-fighting documentary. Plus, get a free recipe book, Amazing Alternatives to Rice, Pasta, and Bread, which contains over 50 delicious and easy-to-prepare recipes that the whole family will love. These gifts are free and waiting for you to grab them in the description box below. Now, back to our video. Okay, so the big questions are, how do you ensure you're getting enough B12, and can you improve absorption? B12 is naturally found in animal products. Fish, meat, poultry, eggs, and milk products are good sources. Within these, organ meats like liver and kidneys are particularly high. If you're able to, go for naturally raised meats such as grass-fed beef instead of grain-fed, or organic pasture-raised eggs rather than caged eggs, which are going to have significantly higher levels of vitamins, as well as a shorter chain fatty acid, which leads to reduced inflammation and ultimately protects against a range of diseases. If you are vegetarian or vegan, it can be difficult to get enough B12 because it's primarily found in animal products. However, a few foods do contain it, such as fortified milk plants, fortified cereals, tempeh, nutritional yeast, marmite, and algae. Some mushroom varieties even contain B12, with one study finding the highest levels in shiitake, black trumpet, golden chanterelle, and lion's mane mushrooms. As for the best non-animal source of vitamin B12, According to a 2014 study published in the journal Nutrients, the winner is dried purple laver, also known as nori. Beyond B12, nori also contains other nutrients that are often lacking for vegetarians, such as iron and omega-3 fatty acids. So if you love sushi, this is a great reason to make your own. Just remember to use cauliflower rice or quinoa and avoid the blood sugar spikes that come with white rice. Next, for optimal B12 absorption, it's important to maintain a healthy gut. The stomach produces something called intrinsic factor, a protein necessary for B12 absorption. Conditions affecting the stomach or parts of the small intestine can disrupt this, so ensuring good gut health can be crucial for B12 absorption. Probiotic foods are your best friend here. Yogurt is a favorite probiotic. Just make sure that it contains live and active cultures, such as lactobacillus, acidophilus, or streptococcus thermophilus. And of course, stay away from yogurts that contain added sugar. The ingredient list shouldn't contain any sugar, sucrose, fructose, high fructose corn syrup, or aspartame. If you want a fruity flavor, add fresh fruit or berries. Kefir is similar to yogurt, but with a thinner consistency and contains even more beneficial bacteria. Sauerkraut or fermented cabbage is high in probiotic digestive enzymes and also a great source of vitamin K, which has potent heart protective benefits. Tempeh is similar to tofu and contains both probiotics and vitamin B12. Kombucha is a probiotic-rich fermented tea and makes a great alternative to soda. And finally, cheeses that are aged but not processed, like Gouda, cheddar, and Swiss, can contain beneficial probiotics. If you suspect you may be deficient in B12, talk to your healthcare provider. There are fairly easy tests for this, and it's well worth the peace of mind. There are a variety of vitamin B12 supplements available if you need, and for those with severe B12 absorption problems, sublingual supplements or injections can be administered, bypassing the digestive system entirely. If you found this useful, click the like button to help spread the word. Ask any questions in the comments below and make sure to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget, you can claim your free gifts by clicking the link in the description below or visiting us at diabeticstalk.com. Also, check out exclusive Diabetics Talk merchandise from our store and sign up as a member to get full access to the Food, Health, and You complete implementation system documentary and more. We want to keep making informative, research-based videos for you. So if you gained value from this video and would like more of it, you can send us a super thanks by clicking the thanks button at the bottom of the video. We're Diabetics Talk, and it's our mission to bring you the best tips and tricks to help you fight diabetes. Thanks for watching. We hope you're having a diabetes-fighting day.